Hey everyone, welcome to another video on OpenWRT. So today I will talk about how to install Plex Media Server on OpenWRT running on the Odyssey x86 J4125 board and the Dual Gigabit Ethernet Carrier board for Raspberry Pi Compute Module 4. If you stay until the end of this video, you will be able to stream all your media stored on the OpenWRT router from anywhere in the world. Don't forget to like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I also welcome you all to join our Discord channel to stay updated with us. So without further ado, let's dive straight into the video. What is Docker? Docker is an open platform for developing, shipping, and running applications. Docker provides the ability to package and run an application in a loosely isolated environment called a container. The isolation and security allow you to run many containers simultaneously on a given host. Containers are lightweight and contain everything needed to run the application, so you do not need to rely on what is currently installed on the host. You can easily share containers while you work and be sure that everyone you share with gets the same container that works in the same way. If you want to learn more about Docker, you can visit this URL. So I will attach this URL in the video description down below. Also, you can visit hub.docker.com, and in here you will find all the Docker containers. So for example, later we will be installing Plex on Docker, so the Plex will be a container. So let's search for Plex. So you can see this is the official Docker container for Plex Media Server. So if you go to explore here, you can find many other containers inside this Docker registry. So now let's talk about Plex. Plex Media Server is a tool that allows you to access the music, pictures, and videos stored on one device with many other devices. You can install Plex Media Server software on a Windows, Mac, or Linux computer, network attached storage device, or even a router. You can stream all your media files stored on your Plex Media Server remotely over the internet and access from anywhere in the world using the Plex app. So the Plex app can be installed on various devices such as computers, mobile phones, and also smart TVs. So now let's go into the Plex website so you can learn more about Plex inside this website, and also here sign up for Plex. So there are many ways to create a Plex account from here. So I have already created a Plex account, so I will not go through this. Now let's log in to our OpenWRT router. So I have explained to you before in the previous video how to install OpenWRT to Odyssey x86 J4125 and the Dual Gigabit Ethernet Carrier Board for Raspberry Pi Compute Module 4. So I will attach that video in the video description down below so that you can watch that video first to install OpenWRT into these two boards. So once a board is powered on and the PC is connected to the router, let's log in to the board. So you'll see the OpenWRT Lucy web interface. Let's log into this. And now we are logged in. So in here, let's navigate to Docker and then overview. So this is the Docker package for OpenWRT, and here you can see some statistics for Docker. Also, if you go here, you can see the containers. So now you don't have containers because we haven't started any container yet. And here you can pull the images from the Docker registry, and networks, you can see the attached networks here, the volumes, the attached volumes, events, and configuration. So I will come back to this later, but for now we have to attach an external storage to the Odyssey x86 board or the Dual Gigabit Ethernet board. So if you are using the Odyssey board, there are different ways of connecting external storage, such as connecting a PCIe SSD, a SATA SSD, an HDD, or a micro SD card. Furthermore, you can also connect USB drives to these USB ports. So when looking at the Dual Gigabit board, you can see there are USB ports here to expand the storage, and also there's a USB header 9-pin USB header so that you can connect an external USB connector to this header to attach USB devices. So once we attach the external storage to these boards, we will store all the media inside this external storage. So now I have attached an external HDD into the Odyssey x86 board. So let's go to system, and inside Diskman you will see the connected HDD drive, and this is the drive that I'm running OpenWRT. So in the external drive, go to edit, and at first let's remove all the partitions. So remove, and then choose GPT here for the partition table, and click new to create a new partition, and then format, and I will format it as ext4. So now this drive is ready to use. Next, let's mount this partition. So go to Diskman again, and under mount point, select the partition that we created before, the 149 GB partition. For the file system, keep it as auto, and then for mount options, type RW, which is read and write. And for the mount point, let's type plex and then mount. So now our partition is mounted here. So now if we go to file assistant here, the file assistant package, you will see the plex directory created. So now let's go to Docker and then images. So here let's grab the plex image. So here I have shown you this page before. So the Docker container for plex media server. And now let's copy this package name and paste it here. Then click on pull. And wait a few seconds until this image is downloaded. So now the image is successfully downloaded. Next, let's create a container. So go to containers and click on add. And for the container name, let's type plex. So for the Docker image, select the plex Docker image. And for the networks, click on host. And here for the environment variables, we have to set a time zone. So if you go to this Docker page in Docker Hub, if you go down, you can see this TZ is the time zone. So let's go to this page, this Wikipedia page. So it has the TZ database name. So I will check for my time zone. Copy this. And then type TZ equals and paste it here. After that, click on plus. And then type plex claim equals. So here, if you check this, so we need to get a claim token for this server. Click on this. So I will sign in from here to plex. So now you will see the claim code. So let's copy this and paste it here. After that, in this section, bind mount, we need to mount a volume. So let's type the mount that we did before, the plex, and then create a new directory, database, and then point it to config. So config will be the directory inside this Docker container. And this is the directory inside OpenWRT. So let's create another one. Plex temp, point it to transcode. And finally, plex media, point to data. So this is where we will store all our media. So once that's done, click on submit. Now click on this and click start to run the container. So now you can see the container is running. So let's type here the IP address of the router, colon, and then type 32400. So that's the port where the plex Docker container is running, and then forward slash web. So this is the initial setup for the Plex media server. So click on this and then give it a name. So let's keep it as OpenWRT. Click on next and then select add library. And then from here I will choose movies, so you can choose anything from here. Next, browse for media folder and I will choose data. So this is where we pointed before, to the Plex media, this directory. So click on add and then add library. After that click next and then done. So now we have successfully installed Plex media server on Docker, which is running on OpenWRT firmware. Next, let's go back to OpenWRT and go to services, network shares. So inside this we can share directories inside this OpenWRT router with the computer. So let's click on add, and for the name let's type Plex, and for the path /Plex. So this is where we mounted the hard drive, and this is also the location of Plex. So let's make it force root so that we will have root access. So by having root access, we can write to this directory, rename files and also delete files. So for the others, just keep them as they are. Click on save and then finally click save and apply. After that's done, go to File Explorer and then click on network and you will see this OpenWRT network location. So double click on this and you will find the Plex directory that we shared before. So let's open it and you will find the three directories, so the database, media and temp. So we want to store all our media inside this media directory. So open this directory. And now let's copy this movie and then paste it here. So you can put all your movies inside this directory. After that, come back to Plex and then click on more, and under this OpenWRT, click on these three dots and then click scan library files. So after that, when you click on movies here, you will see the movie loaded. At the moment I'm running Plex on the OpenWRT router, but however, next I will show you how to get the Plex client applications to watch movies and other content. So if you go to plex.tv and then your media, and you will find this download Plex. So as you can see, under apps and devices, you can choose the device that you want to install the Plex client application. So you can see there are a lot of options for a lot of devices. Now I have set up a TV running the Android operating system, but this TV is not originally a smart TV, it's just a normal TV. But I have used the Raspberry Pi 4 and installed Android TV OS into the Raspberry Pi and converted the TV into a smart TV. So I will attach a link in the video description down below on how to install Android TV OS on the Raspberry Pi 4 and set up your TV as a smart TV. So as you can see, I have installed the Plex client application on this TV. And now let's choose the movie. And here you can see some information about this movie. Finally, let's watch the movie. So here I also want to mention that if you go to settings and go here, remote access. So from here you can configure this Plex media server to be available from anywhere in the world. So as you can see, it says not available outside your network. So this is due to some problems. So if you check here, this link, you can see that this error is there because the router doesn't have UPnP or NAT PNP support. So if your router supports this, then OpenWRT will automatically configure this, or else you can manually configure by doing port forwarding. So you can go through this article to allow the Plex Media Server to be accessible from anywhere in the world. That's it for this video. If you guys like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay updated with us. Also, I welcome you all again to join our Discord channel. See you all in another video.